Hey guys, your boy Cabrera's, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 loop. Who career mode? Where last time left the off? He redeemed. I got my confidence back after her disappointing episode, the episode before. But now my confidence is back. The team is playing well, and hopefully there'll be no more setbacks. Also, to any of you who it concerns, happy Father's Day. Hey, for those of you who are watch, who took time out of your day to watch this. You know, I know most fathers are probably, yeah, better things to do, but there were, but some fathers might have taken their time, you know. Or you could be watching it. Or you could be watching this on another day. I mean, that's completely impossible. It's just that this is going to be recorded and uploaded.
Tyler, along with Alan Smith, broadcasting to you from the Britannia Stadium in Stoke. And this is our match today. It's Stoke City play Liverpool. The Stoke City team, here it is for you. Jack Butland starts in goal. Eric Peters starts with Jeff Cameron.
Off to a nice start.
Positions. Jordan Shaqiri
plays
with
Rodriguez.
Natovic in the wide position.
And he is quickly tackled by some money.
This is the Liverpool side. Aymeric Laporte plays with Raphael Varane in central defence. Felipe Coutinho starts. He was man of the match last time out. In attack, Neymar starts. He's been in tremendous form recently.
Avoids the challenge and buries it. 1-0. Inside 6 minutes. That is a fantastic start.
A goal from Royce. He has a little glance up there and he's aiming for that top left. It's a superb finish.
Probably would have been a penalty if number 2 could be number 12. I can't see if there was a one there. Are very hard to see.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0.
The defender, whether he is 2 or 12. Could have been Sidwell, to be honest. Because I see a 2 on his shirt as well.
He spotted a teammate and he's got the technique as well as the vision.
The player definitely had a 2 on his shirt, or whatever his number was.
A counter-attack could be on here.
Couldn't prevent the cross. And he couldn't stop.
To get numbers forward.
Well, not even the cross couldn't prevent the shot from Marco Royce.
And in goes the cross. Chance from the pass.
Some money. He good defending by Aymeric Laporte.
Neymar.
It was number 12, Mark M. Wilson. Not sure what his first name is.
And he's moved in trying to jostle the opponent.
That time he got the tackle in, stopping the run of Neymar.
Royce. Some options now for the pass.
Rodriguez. Looking for Ronaldo. Finds Butland first. Nathaniel Klein. In. Neymar. 2-0. Or not. It's offside. Apparently Coutinho. Got a touch on that. Probably why it was offside.
This is another angle on it.
Must have struck Coutinho as it was going in. I didn't notice it took a deflection. I thought it took a deflection off the defender. Probably should have known because Coutinho was the one celebrating, not Neymar.
Part of the pitch. Let's go over to Stamford Bridge and Alan McAnally.
There's McAlloy's.
Tottenham Hotspur, 21 minutes played, 1-1.
Straight into
again from Alan McAnally. Thanks, Alan.
Cameron.
Jordan Shaqiri.
Here's Shaqiri. Going down this right hand side, we'll be going up against my left back and his Swedish national team friend and Ricardo Rodriguez. Should be an interesting matchup throughout the game.
The visiting team today had a good
or until
win this
one of them is taken off. I don't normally make defensive substitutions
between the two clubs earlier
necessary.
In the season,
Considering he's one of their best players.
I'm sure they are. They should be.
Unless he's having a bad game.
Well, earlier game, but great chance.
So nothing is complete.
6 points off them.
Unlikely. There's Marco Royce. Avoids Cameron. He's got the pace over. The game is now sending Wilson to come back. It's Rodriguez. Zhao Ma gets enough up on it. It blocked it. Hit his hip. And goes out for the corner. And clears it before I can take it off him again. Timmans will send it back.
Help ease the pressure.
And Cameron clears.
Well, it is Liverpool's match at this point, but there's a lot more of it still to go. And they'll be wondering whether they're good enough to see this through. Plenty of time left all of the
time. Timmans will easily clean that up.
Neymar.
Wilson again. Does well to stop Neymar's run, and I fell. Holds the player as I was trying to get the ball. Also, he fouled the giveaway. Never went back. Ronaldo loses it to short cross. Why the hell not? Ronaldo again. Royce. Timmans.
And the ball knocked away long.
Cleared. Only for a throw.
Gareth Bale.
Which goes to Gareth Bale.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
To Ronaldo. It's coming back to Bale. Timmans. Rodriguez.
Looking for an opening.
Royce.
Good control build up. Got a cross.
Rodriguez again. Whoops, Neymar. Butlin is equal to it.
It's a corner.
Header was good, but the save is better. Ronaldo, that header is good though, because it's 2-0 just before the break. Steve Sidwell is standing on the line, but there's nothing he can do. It actually hits him and goes in. If it hits his head, he probably clears it, but it hits his shoulder and it goes in. And Cristiano Ronaldo makes it 2-0 just before the halftime whistle, which just went. That is a good halftime scoreline. Fortunately, my players are absolutely wrecked, so I'm going to have to make a substitution. I'm going to bring on Divock Origi, unlike Belgium, who for some reason, and even though they were 3-0 up against Ireland, brought in Christian goddamn Benteke. Obviously the Belgian manager does not watch the Premier League, otherwise he know Origi would have been the better choice. Even if Origi is still kind of recovering from an injury, he still would be the far better choice. Not that it matters, they were bound to beat Ireland anyway.
An update from the Etihad, from Ala McAnally.
It's a goal for Hull.
Bell.
50 minutes, please.
Ups it in. Origi, almost straight away. He almost proved my point straight away. He is denied. Nathaniel Klein can't keep it in.
From Alan McInerney,
gonna be an easy ball for Varane. It's almost like there's pretty much no one feel for Stoke at the moment. Only one player currently in my half of the pitch.
Transfer to tell you about Arturo Vidal.
Here we go. Now they're getting forward.
Well, he is a good player, and for me, well
worth
the about £25 million.
I tackled the ball, but it fell to Jam.
That's a good
ball,
isn't it?
Ooh. I cut the ball. Well, and now.
Controlled attacking play.
Cleared.
But it's come to nothing in the end.
But no one wants to get on my clearance, so we'll go straight to Jack Butland from one keeper to another. Fantastic. It was a great shot from my goalkeeper.
Position.
It won't go down as a shot, but it may as well.
Miss him.
We'll have for the lack of interest my players seem to care about.
Ricardo Rodriguez. And in goes the cross.
Rodriguez.
Out of danger there with that clearance.
Neymar.
Defensive block there. No cross coming in. And here's the cross.
Neymar again. Ronaldo 3-0. It's a brace for Cristiano Ronaldo. Oh, it's probably 3 points for me.
A goal from Cristiano Ronaldo. And he's headed it with enough power to beat the keeper above him there.
Jack Butland is a good keeper, but there's only so much a good keeper can do, especially against one of the best players who's in the world. Although he didn't exactly prove that yesterday. He would another disappointing Portuguese performance.
I have to say, it's so one-sided today, but all credit to the team.
Nero.
They're racking up the goals.
Groups. In a group, a lot of people were probably expecting Portugal to walk.
A throw-in. Ricardo Rodriguez.
With Austria being their hardest game, they only have 2 points. Somehow.
By the goalkeeper. And the cross comes in.
Which is four less than I'm guessing people were expecting them to have. I'm saying that I think I would have expected it, Portugal to be winning that group as well, but I don't care about European tournaments and think they should just be abolished because they're just a waste of goddamn time. But no one wants to agree with that.
Let's pop over to Alan McAnally, who's at the Etihad Stadium today. Alan, what have you got?
It's a second goal for Manchester City.
Let's focus on Ronaldo making his way into the box and completing his hat-trick.
Completes a wonderful hat-trick.
And 100% sealing the 3 points. If they weren't already sealed, they are now.
Leading away in a super celebration. To get a hat-trick is a fantastic experience, and he's just done that.
Well, having scored two, he was just so...
26 goals for Cristiano Ronaldo now this season.
On their game today, the other very off-colour. Sometimes being a favourite in a match...
In his first season back in English football.
Problem for this team, is
not a real surprise, very realistic.
Because they've not...
idea if he ever does come back to English football that in his first season back he'd be
shown the class
top goal scorer, if not one of the top goal scorers anyway.
It is Liverpool day. It's
even if he came back from Man United, it'd probably be a safe bet to say he'd be one of the top goal scorers for the season. That's if he ever comes back, and it doesn't look like that's going to happen.
What does this mean for their next game?
Yeah, Stoke City go up against Crystal Palace after this. And I think there'll be a few words spoken in the dressing room afterwards because they've been miserable out there.
Royce. Added time coming up.
Ronaldo loses the ball to Wilson.
Here's Sidwell.
There's the full-time whistle. 4-0 is the final score. Ronaldo gets his hat-trick. Along with a goal from Marco Reus. He's Marco Reus looks like he picked up Man of the Match at 9.8. Good for him. Spurs won a very tight game against Chelsea 3-2. Colet has gone up to 73. Which is good. Offer for Iheanacho, huh? Well, my chief executive says 45 million, and that's what I will say to you, LA Bilbao. We will get back to you shortly. So, that's a yes. That's a yes. That's what that is. Oh crap, I should have disallowed all future offers. Still. I was going to the, sell players, center backs, Aymeric Laporte, disallow future offers. There we go. There we go, that's sorted. There we go. Go to Ramon, freaking hell. Fink, let's just call him Fink. Welcome, Fink. I will never be able to pronounce your full name. And just go, oh wow! I was not expecting that. Look at Bilbao splashing the cash. Huh. Interesting. Was not I don't really know how to say that. On one hand, it's good. On another, I now only have one. I will only have one striker for my secondary team. I got another offer for Iheanacho. Newcastle. You're gonna have to at least match a little Bilbao. Oh, it's 45 million Newcastle. Am I making a mistake? Should I be laying? This is interesting. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? Yeah, have to bring in another striker. I could play one up front. Let's see, would that work? I do have this guy who technically is a striker. Yeah, he'd be a striker. I mean, a lot more game time for Divock Origi and Sean. That is unexpected, and I guess all I can say is it's going to be the highest transfer so far, which right now is Tor Vidal to Man City. But 45 million for Iheanacho. Gonna blow that out of the water. Not typical. Barcelona? Yeah. I believe that. He will definitely play a first team football regularly in game in and out, week in, week out, without a doubt for Barcelona. At 1973 rated. Yeah. Barcelona are taking the fucking piss. don't know, maybe they were thinking try him out for a few seasons, then maybe see if there'd be an option to buy him, but no, just that is 100% not happening. Oh well, Dybala's gone to Seville. How much did he go for? 30.5 million. Oh, it's gonna still be beaten by Iheanacho. Of course, that's if Iheanacho decides to go to a little Bilbao. He could turn him down. I'm not fussed either way. I will have to make a small adjustment to the second team, which I think I have the semi-finals of the Cabo Cup in the next episode. Both matches, I think, are the semi-final first and second leg, which means
hi there, everybody.
Team will
Martin
be playing
Tyler
back
here,
matches,
along with
so Iheanacho
Arsenal and
England
striker Alan Smith.
Yeah, you're coming to think some days and you do get
if he's going to stick around for at least
looking forward to it
for a few more days. He should at least stick around for one of those, and then piss
on here, and he's done it.
Wow, 2 minutes in, and Yuri Tillemans scores a absolute banger against Manchester City. That was from kickoff as well. Mangala passes it to Vidal, who miscontrols it right into the back of Tillemans. I take it, bang, past the goalkeeper. He didn't have a chance. And it's 1-0 in the second minute.
Liverpool, they are in front.
But Man City are regretting signing Arturo Vidal now. Oh, he has an assist. Unfortunately, he assisted me. it won't go down as an assist either, which is disappointing. Because technically it's an assist. Well, he plays for the other team. He did.
To keep the ball. Not anymore.
It assists that goal.
Challenged by the defender. Here's the cross. Goes for it with a fist.
He chested it into the perfect position. For Tillemans to take it and knock it into the goal.
Liverpool will get the
fantastic bit of play from Arturo Vidal.
Neymar. Some options now for the pass.
Neymar. Oops, in. Tillemans! Would you believe it? He scored again? You're a Tillemans. Not signed to be a goal scorer. He's already bagged a brace against Manchester City in 11 minutes. Where's this come from? He only had one goal all season before this. Now he's got two in one game.
At 2-0.
To take his tally to 3. Is he gonna score a hat trick against Man City? Probably.
Ordered this teammates.
Of all my offensive players, probably the most least likely to score a trick against Manchester City.
Well, he's caught offside.
I mean,
to get in behind. He'll say
you wouldn't have been my first thought of who might score for a hat trick in this match. If I was to pick one player, it would have been Ronaldo, then probably Neymar, probably Royce, and probably Ibale. Then it would have been Tillemans. Because after that, it's defenders and my goalkeeper. That is a fantastic reply from Manchester City. Shea Facey. Is it bad that I don't know who he is?
The score! Oh, it's the post! Kolarov. Kevin De Bruyne.
Rodriguez wins a throw off here. Is Navas?
There's
Tillemans, Mr. Two Goals. Tillemans. Two goals, Tillmans. That's an interesting nickname, isn't it? And yeah, it could be three goals. The game is young.
Middlesbrough.
There's already three goals in the game. Fortunately, they're not all mine.
Thank you very much, Alan.
Coutinho. Against Otamendi. Gets past Otamendi. Can he get the shot away? It's Facey who actually blocks it. Is he a defender? He seems to be playing at the right back position, or else he's just a midfielder who gets back a lot. But it's looking like he might be a defender. So, three really unlikely scores. It's probably his first ever Manchester City goal. I can't prove or disprove that. Nathaniel Clyne, thinking if their guy can do it. Oh wait, he'd be playing. Oh, he's on this side, so he's their left back. What happened to that Spanish guy?
Frustrating is this for the other team.
Arlino, or however you pronounce it. What happened to that Spanish guy? I guess Man City, he found someone better. Or maybe he's a right back playing at left back, or maybe he's a midfielder playing at left back. Heck, or maybe I'm overthinking this.
Neymar.
Here's Neymar.
This could be it.
No position he's playing. He's playing striker. He's getting into the box, and he's buried it. 3-1. And the first regular goal scorer to get on the score sheet in this match. After he goes from unlikely sources, Neymar scores his 18th of the season and makes it 3-1.
Now Fernandinho, the one shot, the one on target for Manchester City.
Royce.
We have to say they've been pretty efficient here.
Cristiano Ronaldo!
Ronaldo, he's not offside! I was like sitting there, is he offside? This just seemed like he had loads of space, which is something he did not do against Cristiano Ronaldo. Considering he played for Manchester United for a few years, Man City would have learned that. But apparently they didn't. And lo and behold, it's 4-1.
Trailing here, despite having more possession. Look at those stats.
Yeah, it's quite incredible, really. They've dominated possession and dominated the match.
Oh. And De Bruyne. Get rid of Gareth. Facey again. Aguero! Good save from my goalkeeper. Get rid of it. There we go. Halftime, 4-1. I'm not going to complain too much about their goal. Normally, I'd be really livid. But it was a good effort, especially from a defender standpoint.
On the second 45 minutes, but we'll see how this team does with such a strong position
in the game. I can't confirm or deny where he is a defender. He might just be playing defender.
I think that this would be one of the tightest games we've seen, Alan, but extraordinary, it's gone the other way.
Why didn't you just jump for a header, Neymar? Why did you go for a bicycle kick?
Because the one side has been
I'd understand if someone like Cristiano Ronaldo tried that because he's taller than you. But come on.
Like he's had.
On top of his game out there, and I'm sure he'd be thinking about grabbing his hat trick in the second half.
De Bruyne, Tillmans loses it to Aguero, and it's 4-2. I guess karma is a bitch. De Bruyne loses the ball to a tackle from Tillmans, but it falls to Aguero, and it's an easy shot for any striker, especially Sergio Aguero. You cannot give him that kind of space. I don't know where my center backs were. Apparently not doing their job. Not remembering that they'd already gotten a strike for losing the clean sheet.
And that'll be a corner.
Eaton, I should warn them that's two Nixon, they're not going to lose those strikes because they haven't kept the clean sheet.
Caliber.
Nathaniel Klein, and the ball hits Yaya Toure. And goes out for another corner. It's come to Royce, who hits it. It's another corner.
Corner after corner.
Take it.
Check on the corner count.
Got a whoops in. Vrain headed off the line. And to the man. He's going for glory. Confidence must be high in him.
A chance to have a look at Sergio Aguero's goal. It's with Toure. Yaya Toure. Kevin De Bruyne. Throw in for Liverpool.
Hey, they missed past it, and it's now a throw. Laporte.
I know all of you listening want to know whether this is a done deal or not. We can tell you it's not done, but it might be close, but that's still speculation.
He's very tired. Unfortunately, Tillman's this game is gonna be over, because this is probably gonna be his last chance.
Quite some time.
So he's gonna get a run out one more time in the Liverpool colours.
To make an alteration, they're gonna bring a new player on.
Against his former club.
Good vision to be able to switch the play there. Looking for Yaya Toure. Well, it will be dealt with.
Tillman's with that. Header clearance. Coutinho can't fully get rid of it. And Facey tried it again. And sneaky bastard. Iheanacho is on now.
Kevin De Bruyne.
Can he do this possible last 15 minutes or so of his Liverpool career? Here's Marco Reus. Here is Kylo in Iheanacho. I probably said his first name wrong. Is he gonna score? Oh, Acosta saves it. Ronaldo bears it 5-2. Ooh, another goal in this goal-filled game.
A goal from Cristiano Ronaldo. And the way he's hit it with real power, it's flown away into that top left.
And that's a goal well worth.
And despite having about three or four Man City players in his way, Ronaldo can bury it for his second of the match. And my fifth.
Digest here, 5-2. Still time to play. And on the clock, 8 more minutes.
De Bruyne.
Aguero in the middle. Strong header away again. Cristiano Ronaldo.
Iheanacho will play the ball to Ronaldo. Ronaldo still has it. Despite the attempt from Mangala. Iheanacho! Oh! Tried the spectacular. Acosta denies him again. Coutinho sends it back in.
It's tough for the defenders, they keep conceding these corners.
I think it's a goal kick. Oh no. Oh, must have hit it off a Man City player at some point. That is a throw for me, I'm sure of that.
Neymar.
There's Neymar. Iheanacho, final time. Him in a Liverpool shirt. What can he do? Oh. Is Mullen loses the ball to De Bruyne. And there it is. There's the full-time whistle.
Final whistle is gone now. It's finished.
Token sober.
Hey,
very good win of the... Look at the freaking and such shoots.
Given the two sets of players, wasn't expecting.
Friggin' celebrating like we won the league. It's only January. Haven't won the league yet. Freaking idiots getting the hell of themselves. But 5-2. Very angry. Yeah, I can see those two goals. But, at least I scored the 5. And, yeah, that was Iheanacho's last appearance in a Liverpool shirt. Unfortunately, I couldn't get him anything to commemorate it. And there's confirmation. He's now a 45 million Athletic Bilbao signing. Smashing the into first place in terms of top amounts paid. I like I put Costa up front instead of Sean is the goddamn striker here. Costa is a center forward. What's Sean's alternate position? Striker. Get it right, game. Maybe I'll experiment with the second team. Who knows? I guess we'll have to wait and see in the next episode, of course. Well, I'm definitely not going to sell Diwa Kuri. He just sold Iheanacho. I gotta keep one. And so I have someone to use in my second team. That's going to be the end of the episode. Until next time, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Like if you did, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and until next time, I hope you all.